Okay, Don back. So I'm going to get this plug out, the one that's gotten burnt by the Sears Kenmore microwave drawing too much current for some reason. I haven't investigated it to see if it's actually, it was still working, but it was, dang near melted this, the plug, the male plug and this, while it was running. So luckily my mom noticed it, and I was in here making me something to eat, and in there, not in here, but I forgot my darn, I went to go get my utility knife, and of course I forgot it, but I have a, just remembered, if I can get it out. Actually, an electrician's knife that a friend gave me. It's kind of cool. It's a lot of things. It's pretty. It's kind of a wide edge on it. That's not. But all I want to do. Utility knives have got a sharper edge. But, I mean, not necessarily sharper, but smaller. And I got my little blue natural gloves because they're rubbery. Maybe if I touch that wiring on accident, they'll do enough insulation to protect me, because I don't know which breaker it is, and I don't want to turn off all the breakers. I'm trying to figure it out. So I've done live wire plug changes on it over the years plenty of times. I don't do it unless I really necessarily on the matter of practice. It's always, things can slip, like what I'm doing right here. I'm trying to be careful I don't point that blade in the wrong direction, so that if it slips, it goes in that hole. That's, old screwdriver. I left that like that on purpose, so that it wouldn't be. And these old boxes are metal, so you don't want to go on side to side. You'll find out what breaker it is real quick then. Hopefully. You can do some welding. But, yeah, as they say, don't try this at home. I am at home and I am trying it, but, you kids at home, don't do this. Unless you. If you're old and crazy like me, I'm gonna put these. No, I can't work with those. I was gonna try wearing those leather gloves on top, but I can't work with those. Anyway, those screws are staying. That's the tricky part. Don't grab those screws on the side of the plug. That's what's hot. Okay, that's dusty in there. Now, turn my voltmeter on again, just for grins. And that's what we got here. Yeah, 124.5 this time. But one good thing is my wires look okay. Yeah, they're done. So any signs of that heat? Yeah, no melted insulation. They look pretty pristine, actually. So there's no signs of that heat that was in that plug. Getting to them, yeah. I think I can show it, can I? I can't see the phone and the magnifying glass at the same time to make it focus, but yeah, they look good. So I was having bad dreams about having to Make sure the camera's still on. Having bad dreams about having to try to pull a new wire all the way back to the breaker box. Because I was afraid that it might have... The bottom one. You know, I had swapped the microwave. The new microwave was on the bottom one. I just realized. Yeah, that I was smelling that burner. It was doing the same thing. So, this old plug may just be so old and dirty, and maybe it's got a lot of oxidation. And it's, it may be that it's just built up so much oxidation over the years. Wires are getting all in the way now. All these phone wires and everything. Build up so much oxidation that they, it's my new plug. And this one does have a ground. See, our house is not wired for ground. And, you can't hardly buy those just two-prong plugs anymore anyway. So, this one's going in there. And now you won't have to use a ground lift. If you noticed, I had a ground lift on there. But, let's see. Yeah, I usually put the ground on the bottom. Doesn't really matter, but... I like to keep things the same as much as possible. Okay. Yeah. Wonder if I can figure out... Yeah, I think I'll use my other phone to make a little close-up while I'm at it. Or maybe I can do it when I'm done. Oh, I can actually operate the phone with the gloves on. I tried that once before and it didn't work. Oh, my meter's still on. Okay, so turn it off. The wires look good. They haven't been burned. They really look pretty nice. I'm going to put that upside down. So that doesn't really matter in this case, does it? But this is hot, and I've got my little natural gloves on to try to make sure I don't shock myself. I don't know which breaker it is, and I've done a lot of plug changes and stuff over the years. You know, hot, you just don't touch the wrong thing and use pliers with rubber handles and stuff. Alright. There. That'll be my close-up. Okay, so... Yeah, and this these pliers, this screwdriver has a wooden handle, so if you stay away from the metal, they're actually insulated. So let's make sure it's screwed out enough. And both of them are already out. I used to always screw the one I'm not using in, but sometimes it, you end up having to try to get them back out. And there's your ground lead right there, which I don't have anything to put on it. Let's see. I do have one. Actually, I have two things in this house that I ran new wires. And the bathroom has ground, and my 20-amp circuit that I put out in the garage for my welder has ground. So anyway, let's see. Here's my needle nose without any. I need my needle nose pliers. Let's see if I can tell which one. I don't think, no, if it'll really do it, but let's try it. There we go. Nope. Okay. If you had a ground, you could go to ground and find out which one's the hot lead. You can't. And I don't remember the colors in case you're saying, well, it's the so-and-so color. But even if I did, you don't ever know what people have done. From that, one of the first things I learned back in 1975 is there's no such thing as a color code. Really? Not in reality. So let me move that. Way.
this one first. Okay, now. Looking like it don't want to come off. Might already get me some. And that's not as far as it's going to go without trying to force it out of there. And see, with your rubber, you know, it's a little bit tricky. I don't like to touch the wire itself when it's hot. Unless I have to. If you do, you make sure you use your rubber handles and don't touch the metal. So I'm going to do it. It's really not cooperating very well. You don't want to touch that metal band either, because that can ground you. So let me hold this differently. Kind of hard to do it any differently. Okay, there's one. Yeah. Can't put the other. I'd like to get that one secured, but I really can't put the other one on there. It'd be nice if I had to put some tape on it. What I'm going to do is bend it up way around there by the sheetrock where it can't. Sheetrock doesn't conduct well at all. So actually, it doesn't conduct. So maybe technically it does a little. Okay, there's the other one. Now, let's go ahead and just do it that way. It's all ready to go in there, so it's a little pinching. Yeah, these gloves do save you. They work, but I still would rather use electrician gloves, because I'm pretty sure I was holding the wrong spot just now, but I didn't get shot. Okay, so I'm gonna grab my phone, my other phone, and do a close up of that. And, always have to hit autofocus, it doesn't stay on. Okay, so there's a close up of my new plug. My wires, as I said before, look fine, they don't look. Of course, this one has a ground, but the house is not wired for ground, so it doesn't do anything. But it does save you from having to use a ground lift on your, you know, your cords and stuff, like, you know, your three-prong cords. There we go. Going to put it back in. Put her back in now. Button it up. Let's see.
that. Okay, I'm gonna swap my screwdriver for a Phillips and get it on righty tighty instead of lefty loosey. There. Oops. Okay, I'm gonna get those wires bent so that they line up. Phillips is definitely a lot easier to one hand and then slot, so that's good. Let's see it. Where? There it is. This is what you do when you can't see. You get your lighted magnifying glass. So I don't encourage anyone to do a live hot plug change, but I've been doing this, I've been building maintenance on and off since 1975, so I was taught by experienced people, electricians, and learned how to do, you know, you think it looks easy until you try it at home, and then you get hurt, so don't monkey see, don't monkey do. And 24.2 this time. Huh, that's kind of light, isn't it? But, I mean, that's such a small amount, it just seems odd. Okay, so, I think before I put the cover on there, I should plug something in there. Here we go. I have a radio, a weather radio that I had unplugged a minute ago. If you want to go in there, that is. What's the power button on this thing? Not on any channel. That whole box is kind of loose. That's a tight plug. At least we won't have to worry about anything coming loose or not making a good connection. Makes the whole box. Now I've got it tangled up. So I'm going to put it in a different place until I get ready to put everything back. Now. Gonna leave my little nitrile gloves on until I get all this together, because if your screwdriver slips up in there, you might not like that. Okay. Let's see. There we go. That's done. Now my plug. Get these things off. My hands are sweating like a pig. can't wear those for very long. Cannot stand it. Okay, so the one that got burnt doesn't even want to come off of there. I got another one that's in good shape. Put my knife away, it's laying out there open. It's bubbling. Since I'm just right here, I'm gonna just do it. This is the, I just hope that the wires, they're definitely not stiff or anything, like they've been heated up, but yeah, this, I don't know if it was already tight or if it got tight from being hot, but this, there we go. Oh, I don't even need one of these now. I wanna see. I mean, if they got kind of fused to the plug here, then I may have to replace it or something. Get another. It's just really tight. Oh, there we go. Yep, just what I thought. That one is not in good shape either. I figured that heat had transferred through there. Well, you can see it, but that hole, metal prong on the one side there is just burnt. Yeah, here where I can see it. It's burnt and it's rusty, so this has happened over time. That is pretty. There's probably, what, gave us this big problem. It started there, I guarantee you, and stayed like that because it's been burnt and then rusted. It looks as though it had gotten wet. And, I'm going to grab my other phone and do another one of that. This is good just for my own records even. So I'm going to have to replace. I mean, I could sand on that. But, the phone's all wet away. It gets confused about its orientation. Sometimes when you lay it down. Okay, so. Now. Okay, so I got the ground lift off of my six-way plug, my male plug. Look at that. It has burned and rusted. So that didn't just happen the other day. That's happened over time. And it finally got so bad. Burn and rust. Now, why? I would imagine just the heat brought moisture out of the plastic, out of the air. I don't know. But I mean, this is not in a bathroom. It's in the living room, and it goes around the corner to the microwave. So it's not like it got no moisture. You know, there's no leaks in the roof or anything like that. So, I'm making my close-up video, and I don't know where I am in my other camera. But I could sand it up and everything, but I don't know how much of that is. Well, I guess it wouldn't matter. I mean, it's just the point that needs to make contact. I'm debating about whether I should cut this off. It's not stiff or anything, like the wires got overheated and stiffened. But I could just sand it down, file it down. Or I could cut it off and put a new end on it. It's not melted really. I mean, there's a little sign of heat down there, but it's not melted a lot like ground lift was. That's pretty rough. I wouldn't use that again on a microwave or a heater or anything.
really only use it where I could see what's going on with it, like out in the garage or something. But I wouldn't use that anymore in the house. I got another new one. I got another one in good shape that I had in the garage, and I got a new one. But yeah, I'll decide what to do here in a minute. Okay, so I've never seen one that bad off since 1975. Not that I remember when I started. Of course, well, I mean, I started messing with things around the house when I was a kid. But in 1975, I was 18, and I went and got me a job and got married and started learning this stuff. So it is melted. It's been hot. It bothers me. It'd take 10 minutes to clean it up, and it'd take 5 or 10 minutes to cut it off and put a new... I think I have a brand new end out there. Let me go outside and look. Alright, let me just stop my video, go outside and look for my brand new ends.